Hello, and good afternoon. I'm here today to discuss the concept of deaf gain. You may wonder where this term comes from. Green. Great. This book was published by a colleague of mine in my department, the Department of American Sign Language and Deaf Studies. We look at deaf gain as something that raises the stakes of what it means to be human. And this is, in fact, a recognition of the value of having deaf people on the earth. This is yet more of biodiversity. But I'd like to talk a bit about where the term came from. There was an artist by the name of Aaron Williamson in the United Kingdom, who was a performance artist, very well known. He grew up and being unable to hear and attended doctors, audiologists, and all of them told him that he had lost his hearing. So as he grew up, he began to reflect that nobody had ever told him that in losing hearing, he'd gained deafness. This was somewhat puzzling for him, so he began to wonder why so many parents, upon finding their child was deaf, the first thing they heard and their child was deaf. And now this is very different than somebody who loses hearing later, but a child who is born deaf, immediately when children are born these days, they have hearing screenings and the results are found and the doctors come and tell the parents, "I am so sorry. Your baby has failed his hearing test." The parents are notably shocked, upset, and scared. The baby, only 1 year into the world, has already failed. This has set them up for failure. This concept is astounding. Why do we apologize for a child being deaf? Why do we consider that they have failed? What is it that deafness truly means? Does it mean that the child cannot communicate because they can't hear? This is perceived as a loss, hearing loss. It's thought of as the notion that because of hearing loss, they will have a loss of communication. This is what's envisioned of these children. And in fact, this concept, this conception and perception of hearing as being equated to the ability to communicate, one who can hear and can talk can communicate. But the truth is, deaf people who sign are thought of as signing because they cannot speak, but in truth, communication and speech are not synonymous. So, if a person is signed, is a signer, then these things are usually housed under departments such as the communication disorders. American Sign Language classes throughout the country are often not found in language departments. They're usually found in communication disorders departments, speech and language departments. So what's happening here is that we have created a paradigm that is of great interest. Consider for a moment that the whole thing is a misperception and a misconception. Deaf people sign because all of you, the vast mass of humanity, gesture. We have taken gesture that exists naturally throughout the span of human experience, selected from that, built upon that, a language. Look at the pictures in front of you. I am going to give you a gestural story based on the pictures you see in front of me. So follow me here, okay? Now, you're cheating a little bit because you've got the visual cues to the side, but I'm about to share a story. You see? You all got it, didn't you? Did you get it? Were you able to follow that, more or less? Now, if you couldn't follow me, then really, this is an indicator of your gestural illiteracy. These were basic gestures. And if you're unable to follow it, really, we take these gestures, we compound them in a string and create stories and language. So in fact, there is something gained for humankind. And this is the paradigm shift we need. So you are all users of gesture within your lifespan. We as deaf people have taken that and developed from it a complex and rich linguistic system that is no longer bound to gesture, but it is a language equivalent to any spoken language. This represents a gain for humanity, not merely a gain for deaf people. Imagine for a moment, if you would, if all of you in this room could sign. You use gesture day in, day out. In fact, many of your computer interfaces are gesturally based. You pinch to zoom and zoom in, zoom out. These are based on natural human gestures. Think on that. But it's not merely that. Consider the movie Minority Report, wherein Tom Cruise is using these gestural interfaces to interact with the computer data. Now, he's using gesture in that, but this use of gesture is somewhat limited. Think, though, if this character had been able to interface with the machine using signed language, so much more rich and profound. American Sign Language is the best fit for those using visual, physical, spatial dimensions. So, it makes perfect sense if you're discussing anatomy and physiology to do so in sign language. Imagine if all doctors could do so. If we were talking about blood vessels and so forth, observe as I show you. That conception is clearly depicted through the use of sign. People have discussed at some length that those who sign and the language of film are closely related. There are many parallels between the language of film and the language of sign. In discussing the path of the circulatory system, I can use a tight zoom, a close shot, a wide shot to go into the blood vessel, go into it and see its path. And then you see it progressing as the platelets and sera go through the circulatory system. You see here the blood cells moving along through the blood vessel until they come across an obstruction, which then must be removed to improve blood flow. These things can be explained and depicted so well through sign language. In fact, if you sign clearly, there is no need for animation in your presentation. You can present the information clearly and depict it. And the surgery that is upcoming for a patient could be depicted clearly for a patient. There are advantages to be seen here. And the fact that you all do not sign represents the true loss. And in that book of deaf gain, there are a number of advantages noted for those who have grown up signing. There are a number of processing advantages, facial processing advantage, memory processing advantage, motion processing advantages to be found, bilingual advantages. All of these advantages are part of this notion of those who have grown up signing using a visual, spatial language are quite adept at memorizing spatial orientation and a number of things like this. And when we have compared deaf and hearing persons, deaf who sign and those hearing people who do not, we see marked advantages for those signers. Now, your use of gesture in communication has been present for a long time. And this, in fact, requires eye contact. You cannot, in fact, observe the gestured communication without that eye contact. That face-to-face contact creates connection. When we're looking at each other and talking to each other, we connect more. Rather than imagine the person who's lost in their phone or device and unable to relate to the person they're speaking to. So if I ask you how you are, I'm observing directly your responses. We touch each other more. We see each other more. Imagine if doctors were able to use this, what advantages and gain there would be. In France, there was a corporate communications specialist by the name of Bruno Kahn, who engaged in a great deal of study in order to be able to train corporate communicators, CEOs and the like, to give them tips on communication. In fact, the community he studied were deaf people, looking at the efficiency of their communication and how we could capture these communicative skills and communicate so much more precisely than do hearing people. And so he trains and consults with these corporations, and he learned these communication techniques from deaf people. This is quite startling to many people. They think, and that can't possibly be true. But it is, because the concept that is largely at play in people's mind is that deaf people cannot communicate. But let us ask, what can healthcare and society at large gain from the deaf community? Your notion of communication is skewed. And many people see deaf people as having a communication disorder. But the truth is, deaf people are some of the best communicators that exist, because we communicate using multiple strategies day in, day out, all of our lives. We take this variability in communication for granted. We are constantly creating and using different strategies to communicate with others around us in the world. When we go to the store to go shopping, ordering fast food, there are a number of different visual indicators for the menu. I can point to the number, I can gesture, I can point to the order number 2, but very often the cashier, when I pointed and simply gestured the number 2, are at a loss, begin to speak of me and unable to understand a simple gesture like, right up there, number 2. And really, so finally I'll have to get a paper, write the number 2 on a piece of paper, and they finally get it. But the truth is, this represents the gestural illiteracy at large in society. Deaf people are adept communicators because we do so every day of our lives. This represents a notion of deaf gain that could benefit all of you. In fact, the fact that I've walked out here on this stage and begun to give my presentation in sign, perhaps I'm already seen by you as a failure and you just didn't get it. If so, I'm very sorry for you.